Muerte with Rock Guard Live. I'm out at the Aftershock Festival 2014 with Andy. I don't want to butcher your name. It's like
Andrea.
So you guys just got a new album out, Broken Crown Halo.
Yes.
How is that doing?
It's doing well. I mean, it came out beginning of May 1st, and April 1st, and we've been touring a lot around the album, both in Europe and here. And we're still going strong, and we still have a couple more tours before we maybe start working on some new ideas beginning of the new year. So now we mostly focus on promoting the album still. So it's doing pretty well. People's been happy about it, and they know all the lyrics. So it's doing well.
Singing along, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. So you guys did the, how is it? Hottest Girls in Metal,
yes.
UK tour or something?
Yeah, we did it in the US.
In the US,
yes. We did it twice. We did the very first edition a few years ago with In This Moment and with Intentation, The Gathering. And then we've done it again this year with Sick Puppies, I Set to Kill, and Silver.
Oh, okay.
It's like a tour out of Revolver magazine, which does this feature every year about bands with female members in the lineup. So it's been good. It's been a good tour, and it brought a little different crowd, different bands together, different style for a tour. So it's good.
Sure. I mean, that sounds like a great lineup right there.
Yeah, it was good. It was good being successful, and it's always a pleasure to tour in the States for us. You know, it was our first coming back tour for the new album, so it was good.
And how is that for you, the difference between Europe and the United States?
I mean, there is a difference because in Europe we're more of an established band since a longer time. Mm-hmm. So there are some territories where we do really well, and it's a different market. You know, Europe, you might be big in Italy or in France and not in the UK and Germany or Sweden. So it's more a complex situation. While here, it's more a one big piece of a market. So you have the radio station that are all over the country and the magazines. And so it's a little easier to promote here because it's easier to spread the news, you know, compared to Europe. But we like both situations. We spend a lot of time here, a lot of time in Europe, so we feel as an international band that belongs to both sides,
sure.
You know.
Well, you got a couple new band members, huh?
Yeah, we just changed recently drummer, and we had one guitar player leaving, so we only stayed with one guitar now, so we're four band members plus a new drummer. They decided to retire from the music business, basically. They just moved to a different lifestyle, having kids and moving to the countryside. So we've been together many years, and it's been a very friendly split just because they wanted to don't tour anymore, you know, don't be on the road all the time. They couldn't do it anymore, so it was very, very friendly split and very reasonable situation where we totally understood their will to change their life.
Right. I mean, Gene Simmons said that rock is dead, and basically talking about, you know, a big rock star. Like, where you're gonna come out and sell billions of albums, right?
I mean, that's also for pop music. I think rock will always be here, metal especially, because there's such a loyal fan base. People will always want to listen to metal and rock. But definitely nowadays there's more variety. You know, DJs have become really big, and hip hop is always big as well. So there's more offers. And there are more offers, and there's more difficult to break through. That's for sure. And the record industry has been changing so much because of the downloading and the streaming and the internet. So it's an all new world now, and it's a different way for bands to build a name. It's harder. There's more competition. There's more, you know, 5 minutes out there and then disappear.
Right.
It's difficult, but it's still here, I think. And people will always want to go to a rock concert.
But you really have to be okay with just touring all the time, promoting your album, and don't get the idea that someday you're going to be taking a Learjet from one town.
It's a job, you know. It's a job, and you work for paying your bills first. Then if you can make some extra cash, that's always welcome. But you have first to play music because you love to play music. And then if you can make a living, that's great. Otherwise, it can be a hobby or a passion. But you don't have to come into this business thinking, oh, I'm going to become the new millionaire, because it's not going to happen very easily.
Right. Very few. And do you follow politics at all?
A little bit, yes.
So what do you think about the world situation there?
It's a mess.
Yeah, right?
Somebody's saying that we are living in the Third World War, basically, even if it's just a separated war, little wars that are happening in different territories, you know. I don't really like it. I think we should be over it in 2014. I don't expect people to still go at war, you know, but sadly it's reality. You know, there are so many I think the economical situation of the world has been going too crazy, and then people just can't take it anymore, and now everybody wants to have a cut, you know, and there are different ways to get it, you know. So it's a whole different world now, and it's hard to even take apart, you know, to say this is right, this is wrong, because we as Europe or America has been right on certain things and maybe supported the wrong people very often, and now we have this boiling situation going on. So it's very complicated. It's hard. It's hard to say who's right anymore, you know.
So much hatred, come on, can't we just all love and
Exactly. Life is not so long, you know, and we're here to enjoy it, and I think there's so many good things we could do to enjoy life better than wars or dying for some other people's ideas, you know. I think people should be free to defend themselves and everything, but still you should also be able to talk in 2014.
Yeah, for sure. That should be the first option, right? So, what's next for you guys? What do you got coming up?
We play today here at the festival, then we start a tour in Canada for 2 weeks. Just a few gigs in the West Coast on the way to Vancouver, then starting from coast to coast in Canada, and then a few more shows on the East Coast before we fly home. Stay home for a week, and then we start a European tour with Motionless in White.
Oh, nice.
And then we'll be off for December, January, and coming back here for the Shiprock cruise in Florida and Miami, starting in Miami to the Caribbean in end of January. That's the plan for
now.
Who's
the headliner on that one?
I don't know.
I'm not prepared.
No, it's more of a active rock. I think it's Five Finger Death Punch either, or Avenged Sevenfold, one of those.
Nice. All right. Well.
Yeah.
Oh, the Night's Watch.
Yeah.
What is that? Is that some?
It's part of the Game of Thrones, the TV series. It's It's one of the chapters of the. And it's a cool series. I follow the show, so I like it and I support it. So I think it's one of the. I'm not a lot into fantasy, but that show is. I really like it because it's very brutal, very politics and medieval, more than fantasy oriented. So that's why I really like it. So I'm looking forward for the next season.
I know. I've been reading the books too.
Books are great too.
The books kind of. You watch a show, there's so much going on, you just kind of get lost sometimes. Like who's
I started with the TV show, so I want to finish the TV show first, and then I'm going to read books.
Yeah, well, that's good. All right, anything you want to add before we go?
Yeah, I just want to thank everybody here in North America for the support over the years. It's always a pleasure to come back, and we have such a loyal fan base that we always feel very honored to come back and to get the possibility to promote the band and be here.
Awesome. Well, thanks for
thank
being
you guys.
On Rock Hard Live. Thank you, sir. All right.
Hello, everyone. This is Andrea from Lacuna Coil, and you're just being Rock Hard Live.